And just a few minutes ago, we got this video of hail in Walnut Creek. You can see it and hear it pelting onto the patio there. First Alert meteorologist Darren Peck is here. And Darren, this is kind of just the start of what's going to be kind of a wild weather day, right?
For the rest of this evening, Liz. You can almost kind of think of now through about 8 o'clock really as the final chapter of this storm. Still going to be able to throw us a few isolated thunderstorms. So let me show you the view that we've had on this today, because those were two great images. The snow in Colfax, the hail here at home. And we saw one of the thunderstorms from our camera on Mount Diablo, just a beautiful time lapse that we can watch as the showers increase. You can see the shafts of rain right there. And then eventually they start hitting the lens when it clouds up. And you could see some rain there. And actually, we got some light snow on Mount Diablo earlier, and that camera was high enough that was likely capturing some very short-lived flakes that are still falling with this. So you can see where the thunderstorms are. We're just going to review what we looked at the top of the newscast, because this really is the headline of today. This is the real focus for today's First Alert status. This example, Dublin, that's a good little complex of fairly moderate rain coming down now, approaching 680, 580 interchange. But that rain extends out towards the rest of the Tri-Valley. You can see lightning showing up, being detected clearly over the higher elevations. That's out where all the windmills sit as you start to get into some of the higher hills there. This is what it looked like when we had this complex begin in Napa. It was a fairly impressive complex of thunderstorms. That was the start of this phase where the National Weather Service this afternoon started issuing a series of special weather statements to start raising the awareness on this. This is exactly how it goes on a day like today, where the forecast calls for isolated thunderstorms. That's a perfect example of how this will look. If we play that out and watch what happened, that line then worked its way down 680, and that's what we're seeing here now over the Tri-Valley. But there's going to be a regeneration. Let's put this into the future cast. So we switch from live First Alert Doppler. We put the computer forecast imagery on here, and this is the high resolution model for the short term stuff, which is really going to do the best job. And watch what it shows. More of this kind of regeneration likely between now. We're looking at the 5 o'clock hour. That's pretty much what we're seeing here. But here we are in the 6 o'clock hour. This will take us now into the 7 o'clock hour. And by the time we get to about 8 o'clock, it's going to start winding down. But you notice where it is? It's all in the same spot. It's all the Inland East Bay. So we're not really seeing a whole lot of that anywhere else. Most of us have blue sky out there. And here's a wide view of it, just to kind of get the big picture notion of how confined this will be. All right, once we're done with that for tonight, we're done. So what stands out about tomorrow is how cold it's going to get. So just a review on this, we're going to do pretty much the same numbers again tomorrow morning that we did this morning. So it's going to be a lot of low 40s. We're going to do some upper 30s tomorrow. And it'll be mid-30s if you're in the North Bay Valleys. Upper 30s will be for the Tri-Valley. There's the city. You're going down to the low 40s tomorrow. And the numbers will be in the mid-30s for places like Santa Rosa. So it's a cold start to the morning. But the afternoons, both Saturday and Sunday, are going to be just fine. They're not going to warm up a whole lot. We're still going to be looking at temperatures that are going to be held down into the 60s. So let's get into the 7-day forecast, and I'll show you what that looks like. And we're going to use the microclimate that would spotlight the inland microclimate here. We keep some clouds around for the weekend. Low to mid 60s is the best we can do. But by Monday, we start the warm up. Plenty of sunshine, mid 70s. And then that really just keeps stair stepping its way up. And by the time we get to Thursday and Friday of next week, we are low 80s, and if you want to be technical about it, 83 on Friday, you could statistically say you're approaching the mid 80s at that point. So it's going to be warm next week, Liz.